Let's Talk with Lakshmi viewers, welcome back to this week's episode of Let's Talk with Lakshmi. This week we'll be filming at the beautiful Mantra Lounge. I'd like to thank Mantra Lounge for letting us film here. Now, this week's episode is dedicated to our beauties in the community. You've seen a couple of them on the show before, and today we'll be interviewing some of the organizers. So it's indeed my pleasure and privilege to bring on no stranger to our community. We've got Harry Gangadine. Harry, how are you today?
I'm great. How are you, Lakshmi?
I am doing fabulous, even more fabulous when I get to see you and some of your beauty queens.
Thanks.
Well, Harry, I know you've been doing the Universal Precious Gems of America pageant for 3 years now. So let me just ask you, what do you gain by doing these pageants?
I gain a self of security because I think just having these pageants instill the girls in our community, we empower them to become better motivators. They gain self-esteem. They gain motivation, integrity, poise, the ability to speak in public. And I feel by having these pageants, the girls can gain by learning about different cultures. Our pageant is not only about one culture. We instill every race, every color in our pageant. And we have different color queens to prove it. My first queen that won the actual pageant, she's half African American and half Korean.
Now, that's actually quite interesting. I mean, I have noticed with your pageant, different from, you know, normally with the Indo-Caribbean community, that you do have different ethnicities in the pageant. Now, being that you're part of the Indo-Caribbean community, why did you decide to go outside of the box and have these other ethnicities in your pageant?
I decided to have that because I think we shouldn't exclude anyone from a pageant. Yeah. If they want to be in the pageant, regardless of the color, their shape, their size, even age. I've seen many pageants that's against girls because of their age. They age them out of 25, which is still young to me. And I think all these things are wrong. For me, it's all about how you feel about yourself coming into the pageant, showing what you could do, no matter what age you are. I've seen competing with my daughter in the American pageant as a pageant dad. I've seen a 6-year-old beat a 30-year-old winning the whole pageant, where I've seen the opposite. I've seen a 30-year-old beating teenagers, beating a 21-year-old, and that's what we stand about. We want to empower women of all races, color, shape, size, that every woman is beautiful. You don't have to look a certain way. You don't have to feel a certain way. You just have to be yourself, be confident, and follow your dreams, and you can achieve whatever you're looking for.
I mean, that's wonderful what you just said, that every woman, no matter what size, what shape, what age, what color, we're all beautiful. You know, Harry, I want to say that you're a pageant dad. Now, most people looking at this show right now might be like, I've never really seen a pageant dad. I mean, why did you become a pageant dad? What's behind that?
It started because of my daughter. Me and her are very close. She's close with my wife. But certain things she would ask me. And she started looking at the show's Toddler and Tiaras at the age of 3 years old. And she wanted to be on the show. She would go to her mother, she would come to me, and we would brush her off. Tomorrow, yes, tomorrow. You want to be on the show? Yes. I'll get you on the show tomorrow. But it got to the point where I was like, Melina, do you really want to be in this? Are you ready for this? And she said, yeah. She was mimicking the girls on TV. She was doing everything they were doing. So I enrolled her in her first pageant. She won a title. It wasn't the highest title. But hey, at that point, she was the only Indian inside. And I felt that I'm going to take her far. I'm going to try to take her and see where she can go with this. And because of these pageants, she's been on Ricky Lake. She's been on Toddler and Tiaras. She was signed with MMG Models, which is the biggest modeling agency in Canada and the USA, all at 6 years old. And she's performed in the West Indian community at Maracas, opening with Ravi B. She's been in fashion shows at the Starlight Pavilion. She's been in the Diwali show, trying to raise money for the victims of Hurricane Sandy in the fashion shows. So she's been doing great things at 6 years old. And I encourage everybody from our community, bring your girls out. Modeling and pageantry is not a bad thing. I know in the Indian community, I know a lot of people wonder their girls to be doctors and be lawyers, but sometimes that's not their passion. They should let them follow their heart. I'm letting my daughter follow her heart, and look where she's reached.
Well, Harry, that's really wonderful. I mean, Melina is only 6 years old and she has accomplished so much. And more so, she has influenced you to be this wonderful pageant dad that you are and for doing these pageants. So what made you start this Miss Universal Gems of America pageant?
When I look at it, what's going on, we've competed outstate where if you go to Pennsylvania, if you go to Connecticut, and if you go to New Jersey, and I'm not saying all pageants, but we've been, it's been like a Miss America experience where you go out of state. If you're not a certain color or you don't have a certain color eye or a certain color hair, you're discriminated against, you know? Like Nina Davaluri, she's a big influence and a big role model and heroine to the whole Indian community, right? You know? And I was trying for Melina to do that for the West Indian community. So I started this pageant to bring our girls into it because our girls are beautiful, whether they're fair, they're brown, they're dark, whether they're skinny or they're a little bit big, our girls are beautiful too, and they should feel like that about themselves.
And I mean, of course, kudos to Nina. I mean, I think every Indian girl at home or every brown girl, any other ethnic girl looking at Nina, she's influenced them. She's given them courage to say, you know what? Maybe I can do it too. So, Harry, I know these pageants have been going on for about 3 years now. This is your third year. Now, one important thing, you know, people looking at this at home and they're going to come out to the pageant, you know what people always wonder? They wonder, how do you pick your judges? So, how do you pick your judges, Harry?
Well, we pick our judges at random. We all, at every pageant, we try to have different judges because different judges have different opinions. We base our judges. We've had pageant moms as judges. We've had people as former queens as judges, people in the pageant industry. They know what to look for. They know what a pageant consists of. Like the last pageant, we have Sundari, the Indian goddess, who's been in the gay Caribbean pageant. We have Ernie Peppers, who's been in the pageant industry for quite a few years. I've had a few of my pageant moms coming on right now. That's going to be, you're going to be talking to later to their daughters. I've had you, Miss Lakshmi. You know what to look for. So we try to change our pageant judges every time. They look for different things. And they all know what to look for in the pageant industry.
So now that we know about the judges, tell me, what are some of the prizes, Harry?
Well, we've had some big prizes within our pageant. We work with Future Star Studios, which was sponsoring a $7,200 scholarship to the winner. And for anybody that didn't qualify, they gave every other girl a $3,600 scholarship. And Future Stars, you could Google them, you could look them up. They're a big school in the city, and they teach modeling, acting, singing, and dancing. They've had many actors and actresses come out of CBS, and you could Google them, many shows. We've worked with Barbizon, which is, for our last pageant, the biggest modeling agency. They've been around for 75 years. My current queen, Arnethia, is actually going there. She's gaining a lot, even though she's so experienced. You know, she's gaining a lot from them. We've worked with Travel Span. They have sponsored a trip to Trinidad, which was wonderful. My last queen, Jackie, won. We've worked with many different organizations to sponsor these prizes, and we hope to keep on working with many more organizations. Our next pageant, we're working with a really big agency called G&G Agency. They're going to be judging the pageant. They're an agency from Long Island that promotes these girls.
Well, this all sounds really great. I mean, it sounds like you put your hard work and your dedication in it, and you're really looking out for the girls. I mean, with partnering up with big companies, big Indo-Caribbean companies, as well as American companies, I can see that you do have the best of interest in your girls. So what we're going to do now is, I know Savvy's also here. She's your partner. What we're going to do is we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll talk a little bit with Savvy.
Great. The Miss Universal Precious Gems of America was formed on February 5th, 2013, and is registered to have pageants anywhere in the USA. We hope to bring you quality pageants and shows that will provide quality entertainment. Our vision is to promote and empower women. We believe women are beautiful regardless of color, race, shape, size, and age. We hope by having these pageants to instill confidence, poise, self-esteem, integrity, and the ability to speak in public for these young women. We believe that by empowering young women through hard work and dedication, they can make their dream come true.
2 months ago, after my mother's hospitalization, the doctors wanted to put her in hospice. And I'm like, you know, they deemed her terminal. And I saw Mr. Thakur, I think the founder, on TV, and he was advertising this Indian community in Kings Harbor. It's a great Indian community where my mother feels at home, and she expresses her happiness to me whenever I come.
I know when I come, I feel happy. I stay couple and I see everybody, and I'm so happy.
I brought my mother here like a month and a half ago, and I haven't regretted my decision. It's one of the best decisions I've made for my mother. It's a home away from home.
Nanking Chain of Restaurants serves a large variety of Chinese, Thai, and Indian cuisine, prepared by seasoned chefs and experienced professionals. Check out one of Nanking's newest restaurants at 134-07 Rockaway Boulevard, South Ocean Park, New York. Nanking proudly serves halal meats, vegetarian, non-vegetarian, and seafood delicacies. Nanking Restaurants caters to private and corporate events for all occasions in their restaurants and banquet halls. Nanking Restaurants, a chain of restaurants which are also conveniently located in South Springfield, New Jersey, Jersey City, New Jersey, Iceland, New Jersey, New York, New York, Atlantic City, New Jersey, New Hyde Park, Long Island, and the grand opening of their newest location at 134-07 Rockaway Boulevard, South Ozone Park, New York. Reserve your table today at 718-323-3555. That's 718-323-3555. For more information, visit nankingrestaurantgroup.com.
Oh, Sajana.
Hello, Sitaram. I'm Rajesh Sukraj. I would like to invite the community and everyone out there to come and support Mehfil E Sangeet. This is our second concert. We have all the way from Trinidad and Tobago, Pandit Munilal Maharaj and his wife Navita Maharaj, coming to really, really excite and steal the hearts of everyone that's coming to the show. Along with, we have Esther Ramdeen, Roshan Ramdeen, the Jagjeet of the century. We have the man bringing the Guyana flag to Bhuvaneshwar. We have Ashton Ramdihal. We also have Kajal, the Chutney Queen, and also Filmy and Folk, the best singer you want to hear. She is going to charm your heart. We also have Uncle Sultan Rahmat. He is really an established singer from Trinidad and Tobago, a man of many music and many years of entertaining. And also we have Ravi Charan, the tabla, Nawaz. I mean, this kid is really fantastic. When you hear him, you will want to dance. Also, we have backed by the Gemini Band, the number one band in New York. They will also be here supporting the show. It's going to be a great show. I myself have a big surprise for her. We have a guest artist coming. So please come out and support Shiv Raja Music. We have tickets. Tickets are $25, only $25. So please come and support our culture, our dharma. We will see you there.
Welcome back, viewers. Well, we are still here at the beautiful Mantra Lounge in Queens, New York, and now we have Savvy on with us. Now, Savvy is also one of the organizers of the UPGOA pageant right here in New York City. So, Savvy, tell me, what does UPGOA mean to you?
Miss Universe's Precious Gems of America. That's the meaning for me. But I have a different meaning towards it. I hold the whole universe in the palm of my hand.
Okay.
That's universal. Precious is all the girls that are very precious and dear to us. Gems is all the diamond stone, all the colorful stone, the sapphire, the rubies, the diamonds. Those are all precious gems to us, which we give to the girls, which to wear on top of their heads.
Right.
And America, it's all taking place here, right here in America.
So Savvy, I know that you have a background in shows. You told me that you have done shows in Trinidad as well as in New York City, a history of about 30 years in show business. So having so much history and experience in show business, tell me, how do you select your girls?
Wonderful question. We do not select our girls. Okay. We do every girl is our pride and joy. Every creed, race, color, size, we accept each and every one of the girls. No matter where you come from, whatever country you come from, we all take you, groom you, train you, and put you out there. And they do their best. That's the way we choose our girls. We do not neglect anyone. We give them that opportunity to do whatever they want to do, which none of the other organization will do that because they look at shapes and sizes. We do not. We give even mothers, we give them that opportunity to do what they want to do on our show. When we train them, put them there, they are well-trained, groomed. We are satisfied with whatever they are doing. And we are happy with each and every one of our girl performance.
So Savvy, UPGOA is categorized as a beauty pageant, right? So considering that you're not just looking at what's on the outside with your girls, right? The beauty on the outside, you're also looking at what's skin deep, right? What's the beauty inside as well. So considering that, let's say it's not the typical beauty pageant where you're primarily judging beauty, right? What would you say your judges do look for?
The judges are looking for confidence in young ladies, self-esteem, and the way you portray yourself by answering your question, the way you walk, you speak to each other, the way you model. This is what judges are looking for. And it gives the young ladies a lot of more empowerment when they get a full training from us and answer their questions. It makes them much more powerful, strong, to go out there and do their best.
So, Savvy, tell me, throughout this whole process of training and showing them how to walk and talk and building the confidence, what is the number one advice that you give to these girls through this entire process?
Number one advice I would give to all the girls is to be yourself. Go out there, have fun, but make it. You know, everything comes from inside of you, not the outside. Whatever you say, it's being judged, it's being looked upon. So you have to do everything from within yourself. And always have fun when you go out there. Everyone wants to be a winner. Everyone wants to have a crown. But when you go out there, you just decide to have fun, do whatever it takes, and just enjoy the show.
Well, like I told Harry, I know this is the third year for your pageant. What kind of reactions have you and Harry been getting after these pageants?
Well, actually, we get a lot of response and excellent response from the public because they love what we are doing, because most of our shows that we are putting out, our pageant, is a bit different from other pageants.
What makes yours different?
Because we incorporate all different cultures of dancing, singing. And we give everyone that opportunity, that chance to come out there and show what you can do. We do not judge you from whatever you sing or dance. We give you that opportunity. And this is what the people out there loves with us. And we do it from our heart, not from our lips, from our hearts. And whatever Harry and I do, we do it on our own. Yes.
Well, I mean, I have to commend you guys for taking the step, being different, stepping out of the box, you know, and promoting the beauties of our community. And not only our Indo-Caribbean beauties, but you're promoting, like Harry said, all sizes, all shapes, all colors, all creeds. So I know Lisa's also here on set at Mantra. So what we're going to do is Lisa's a pageant mom as well. We're going to bring her on and find out how it is being a parent and being in pageants.
As you know, this pageant highlights this evening with physical beauty of our Caribbean American contestants with their inner beauty, intelligence, talent, and culture of these highly ambitious young ladies with excellent, outstanding, and courage that motivate these young ladies to enter this pageant. Each and every one is a winner in their own way. Have fun and enjoy this evening. Thank you to the parents for allowing us to have and train your young, beautiful children. Without you and your support, this evening could not be possible. We are empowering these young ladies with strong platform to make their dreams come true. Katie Schiffer, Marsha Thompson, Ramaya Jordan, Afisa Khan, Lily Barra, Sabina Singh. Give them a big round of applause. Come on, guys. What happened?
Welcome to Platinum Celebrations Incorporation, event planner and on-day coordinators. Formal or casual, large or intimate, held at a private residence, dazzling venue, or the beach. Platinum Celebrations' unparalleled service and attention to details will take your special occasion from the ordinary to the extraordinary. As a full-service event planning company, our service goes beyond design and decor to encompass entertainment, linen and table settings, flower arrangements, party favors, invitations, photography, and so much more. From selecting the perfect site to achieving the perfect mood. We promise to guide you through the planning process from beginning to end, and we are on site throughout the entire event to ensure all of your time and money invested goes according to your liking. Contact Shivy at 347-432-8545 for a free consultation. Remember, Platinum Celebrations is here for your special day. Elegant floral design. We can help you beautify your event. No occasion is too big or too small. We specialize in floral decor and party planning for every event. Please call 718-322-9786. Please use promo code Lakshmi for a discount.
Hello, Sitaram. I'm Rajesh Sakraj. I would like to invite the community and everyone out there to come and support Mehfil E Sangeet. This is our second concert. We have all the way from Trinidad and Tobago, Pandit Munilal Maharaj and his wife Navita Maharaj coming to really, really excite and steal the hearts of everyone that's coming to the show. Along with, we have Esther Ramdeen, Roshan Ramdeen, the Jagjeet of the century. We have the man bringing the Guyana flag to Bhubaneswar. We have Ashton Ramdihal. We also have Kajal, the Chutney Queen, and also Filmy and Folk, the best singer you want to hear. She's going to charm your heart. We also have Uncle Sultan Rahmat. He is really an established singer from Trinidad and Tobago, a man of many music and many years of entertaining. And also we have Ravi Charan, the tabla, Nawaz. I mean, this kid is really fantastic. When you hear him, you will want to dance. Also, we have backed by the Gemini band, the number one band in New York. They will also be here supporting the show. It's going to be a great show. I myself have a big surprise for her. We have a guest artist coming. So please come out and support Shiv Raja Music. We have tickets. Tickets are $25, only $25. So please come and support our culture, our Dharma. We will see you there.
Welcome back, viewers. We are here still at Mantra Lounge. You know, right after this, I think we have to go get some of their wonderful shrimp wontons. But on set right now, we are with Lisa Gangadine. She is the vice president of the UPGOA pageant. But not only that, she's also a pageant mom. So, Lisa, tell me, what is it like really being a pageant mom? I could imagine the pressure, but you tell me, what is it like?
Well, being a pageant mom is a lot of fun, actually.
Okay.
It's a little bit of stress because it's a little bit hectic. You know, you want to make sure your daughter looks her best at that day of the pageant. But it's also a lot of fun because you end up meeting a lot of people. So many people I've met, and I've become so much good friends with so many people out there. It's like everybody's, I walk straight and everybody's like, Lisa, how you doing? And I'm like, do I know you? And then they're like, yeah, we met at this pageant. I'm like, oh yeah, you're this one mom, this girl's mom. And it's like really funny because, you know, we form like a motherhood, but yet we have like a sisterhood in it. And it's so much fun with the kids and doing everything together. You build a bond with your daughter.
Wonderful. Now, Lisa, you are the mom of Melina.
Yes.
Melina is the six-year-old who has won, I'm sure, over 30 pageants by now, right?
Yes, she has now she has like 40 titles. And 40 sashes.
Wow, 40 pageants. That's amazing. I mean, how do you even keep up with 40 pageants with a six-year-old?
It's difficult. Doing pageantry is difficult. But, you know, we do it for the fun of it. She likes to do it, and we do it for Melina. She wants to do it. As long as she's having fun, we're having fun with her.
Now, I have to say, Melina's very lucky. She has a supportive pageant dad, who's Harry, your husband. And of course, now she has you, a very supportive pageant mom. Now, Lisa, tell me, anybody watching this, whether it be a future contestant or parents watching this, what advice would you give to a parent that may have a child that wants to get into modeling?
Well, in pageantry, from my perspective as a parent, there's a lot of ups and downs with it. As long as the daughter wants to do it for the right reasons, it's all good. Because you know what? In everything, there's good and there's bad. With pageantry, it's the same thing. And with my daughter, I'm doing it because she loves to do it. And for anybody who has that passion and it wants to express it in that way by showing off, doing their talent, doing outfit of choice, being there just to show their true their personality, it's a positive thing. It's a good thing. It helps bring the girls out. It breaks their shell. So most of the girls have very low self-esteem, especially in the West Indian community. We find a lot of girls have very low self-esteem. And from my experience with my daughter, it helps break them out of that, and they become very confident out there. They build their self-esteem. Because my daughter, when she first started pageant, she was 3 years old, and she used to hide behind me and cry when people used to say hello to her. And since she started doing pageantry, now she goes out there without somebody even saying hello. She goes up to a stranger and be like, hi, how are you? My name is Melina. What's yours? And she have a conversation like a grown up. And, you know, that's something good because it helps them excel at school, because it does for my daughter.
Well, that's wonderful. I mean, I have to commend UPGOA for doing such fabulous work in the community, especially with our children, with our girls. Now, I know we have some of the girls here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to meet these girls.
That would be fabulous. The girls, they can't wait.
When thinking of shipping a barrel, box, or sending money back home, think of the name you can trust. Think Lapakan. Lapakan has been serving our community for over 25 years, and a significant portion of every dollar spent at Lapakan goes to work in our community here and back home. Together, we are making a difference. For your shipping and money transfer needs, call Lapakan. Lapakan, the name we can trust.
For all your special private and professional occasions, no event is too big or too small. We cover it all. Contact the professional source for all your party or special occasion needs. we have you covered at Star Party Rentals. Call us 516-239-2242. Please mention Let's Talk with Lakshmi for discount pricing.
Namaste. Welcome to the East Indian Music Academy. School, you can visit us on the website www.eima.us. For further information, you can also call 718-738-7836. I hope to see you soon.
Hello, Sitaram. I'm Rajesh Sakraj. I would like to invite the community and everyone out there to come and support Mehfil E Sangeet. This is our second concert. We have all the way from Trinidad and Tobago, Pandit Munilal Maharaj and his wife Navita Maharaj coming to really, really excite and steal the hearts of everyone that's coming to the show. Along with, we have Esther Ramdeen, Roshan Ramdeen, the Jagjeet of the century. We have the man bringing the Guyana flag to Bhuvaneshwar. We have Ashton Ramdihal. We also have Kajal, the Chutney Queen, and also Filmy and Folk, the best singer you want to hear. She's going to charm your heart. We also have Uncle Sultan Rahmat. He is really an established singer from Trinidad and Tobago, a man of many music and many years of entertaining. And also we have Ravi Charan, the tabla, Nawaz. I mean, this kid is really fantastic. When you hear him, you will want to dance. Also, we have backed by the Gemini band, the number one band in New York. They will also be here supporting the show. It's going to be a great show. I myself have a big surprise for her. We have a guest artist coming. So please come out and support Shiv Raja Music. We have tickets. Tickets are $25. Only $25, so please come and support our culture, our dharma. We will see you there.
Oh my God, I tell you.
Lisa Khan, Lily Barrow, and Sabina Singh.